you for the introductions. Also, I want to thank the organizer of this meeting for having given me the honor to talk in this conference in honor of Marcel Berger. So Marcel Berger was my grandfather. My father is here, was Sylvain Gallo. And as mathematically, I want to say. And I'm very... And I'm very proud to belong to the Marcel Berger schools because they are founded schools. He opened many doors in mathematics for us to enjoy our mathematics. So I'm very happy to be here. And also something that I want to mention, and in my mathematical educations, I was impressed by the end of the book that Marcel brought with Berger-Gostio, with the book Berger-Gostio on curves and surface. It contained two chapters that are devoted to the local and the global geometries of surface. And it was a very nice survey of this geometry, both from the old results, classical results from surface, and also all the new areas that were open at those times. For instance, in this book, it was explained the result of the minimal volumes of R2, the result by Bavard and Pierre Ponsu. So it was really belonged to geometry belonged to this long history, so it was very important for me to be sure that I want to do geometry. Okay, so I'm going to talk about a joint. Project with Clara Aldana in Luxembourg. And my colleague Samuel Tapi. So the this is a very general question. Under which geometrical conditions do we get geometric compactness within a conformal class? So before, in 20 minutes, I will give the more precise questions that I'm not able to, we are not able to solve. But then before, I want to give some well-known results. So these first questions arose in the questions of isospectral manifolds. So you consider a closed Riemannian manifold. And if f is a smooth function, I will denote GF is the conformal metric that is conformal to G naught with the factor exponential 2F. Okay, and if okay, is the spectrum of the Laplacians associated to GF, then you get the following results. If n is 2, this is due to Osgood Phillips and Sarnak, and if n is 3, so there are two group of people, you have Brooks Perry and Young. So I think this is in, and then you have Chang and Young in. Okay, so they obtain the following results. If you take the set of F, for all k integer, the eigenvalues, the kth eigenvalues, is equals to the k eigenvalues of G naught. Okay, then this is compact. Okay, and this is not, we don't know if it is true in higher dimensions. Okay, in dimension 2, in fact, what do we get? Once we get this from the technique developed by Osgood Phillips Sarnak, you get compactness of compact on conformal class with a given spectrum. Okay, and then there is another result. If the dimension is greater than 3, then there is a result by Gursky. So it is the following result. So assume you take P, a real number that is greater than n over 2, and you get V and lambda. So this is positive number, and you consider the set of functions such that the full Riemannian curvature of GF to the power P is bounded by lambda, and the fact that the volumes say is fixed. Then what you obtain is that this set is pre-compact in C1 alpha for all alpha between 0 and 1. And there are examples. Of Chang Yoski Wolf. It is not possible to remove the LP. Okay, so you can cook up examples where the conformal factor blew up, so go to zero, okay, or the exponential go to plus infinity or minus infinity, where you keep the ln over 2 norms of the full curvature tensor. Okay, then there are several others. So this was in fact the starting point for the reflection. It was, yeah, this hypothesis seems to be very strong, but on the other side you have this example. So, and then we consult the literature, and there are other examples. So I want to say that there is a result by Simon Brendel in 2003. This thing, so it is on the round sphere. Okay, so you take a real number, and you take, so this is set of F, where you get the following. So you assume that the Q curvature asset to this symmetric to the squared is bounded by E, and the fact that the full curvature is bigger than a quantity that is the one zero minus one over. Okay. So the Q curvature is a curvature that generalizes the Gaussian curvature in higher dimensions that satisfies also some nice conformal transformations. Okay, and perhaps with volumes. Here it's two.
Yeah,
it's power two, yes. Okay, and what? So, and the volume is the same. So you obtain that the set of F is bounded in Hn. Okay, you get n derivative in L2. And then from Sobolev embedding, you get precompactness. Okay, and now there is also another story where this kind of compactness within a conformal class is important, is about the Aubin conjecture. Okay, it's about you take the.
Can you raise the middle board, please?
Is it better?
Yes.
Thank you. Okay, you take set at F, so that the scalar curvature of GF is constant positive, and the volumes. Is one. Okay, the question was about the compactness of this set. Okay, and in fact the result is quite strange. So if N is below then it's compact. So this is a series of results. You have in lower dimension, this is due to several people depending on the dimensions. Okay, so I think it's Yai Yan Zhang and this is not compact, and this is due to Brendel and then to Marquez, Brendel-Marquez. And this is 2008, 2009. Okay, and this result was also in 2008. Okay, and finally the last result that I want to talk about, perhaps here. It is you have a result by Mathiesen in 2016, published in a nice journal, the Annales de la Faculté des Sciences de Toulouse. And it's a very nice argument. So something is able to get the same conclusions as Gursky's papers, but with a replacement. So he only assumed some things on the scalar curvature, but he had some things about on the spectrums. The volumes of the round sphere. So this is a normalization. Okay. He assumed that the scalar curvature again, P is larger than n over 2, and this is larger than 1. Okay, and he assumes the fact that the first eigenvalues of M is greater than n plus 1. So the first eigenvalue is not equal to the one of the sphere. Okay. Then you obtain is precompact in C1 alpha. Okay, so he's able to replace all the hypotheses on the full curvature tensor by only a spectral hypothesis. Okay, so but now if you go to the literature on the precompactness of Riemannian metrics, there are a lot of other results. And then you can ask, if you make one of these hypotheses, what is the constraint you get on the conformal class? Okay, so. You get if you get the set F, the set of with set bounded on the diameter and a lower bound on the Ricci curvature. Okay, this set is precompact. In the Gromov of the Dorff topology. Okay, and then you have the works of Chigger, Koldings, Chans, and others that describes this limit space. Yeah, but it's for in general. So the question is, if you stay in a conformal class, did you get a better understanding or perhaps better results, okay? Of the limit. Yeah, because here the precompactness is as a metric spaces. So it says that it converges to a metric space. It does not say that the limit is a Riemannian manifold or a manifold even, and distance is not necessarily, even if it's a manifold, is not necessarily related to the ground matrix. It's not necessarily conformal. Okay, so now I'm going to make a remark. Okay, so the volumes okay, this is given by this quantity. Okay, but now if you look at what is okay, you take the gradient for the metric G naught. Okay, the distance function. So the distance, if you assume f is smooth, this all are Lipschitz, so this is differentiable almost everywhere. And in fact, what you get that this is equals to almost everywhere. Okay, so this is you get always a kind of this is a Lipschitz function, but what you get for free is a kind of Sobolev regularity from the volume estimate. Volume imply W1n estimate on the distance. But it's very weak, okay? And moreover, there is some troubles because this Sobolev space is precisely the one that do not embed in continuous functions. It is the critical ones. But if you add a little bit more, you take a p here that is bigger than n, and you assume a fix, then you get W1p a priori results for the distance, and you get a C alpha estimate, and from this you can extract subsequence that converge and give you convergence in the Gromov-Hausdorff sense. Distance. C alpha estimates on the distance with respect to the originals D zero. Okay, and then from this by Ascoli you get you can extract subsequence that converge the distance and get some things. Okay, so let me give, yes, Shkari is not very geometrical, so the game is now how you can get these assumptions from geometry. And this is the first result. So n is larger than 3. Okay, so you fix a compact closed manifold with Gromov matrix, and you look at conformal metrics. So the volumes is fixed, and moreover, the fact that the total you take the scalar curvature of this metric, you only take its positive part to the critical exponent. And what you assume it's far from being the one of the sphere. Okay? So this is one of the sphere minus delta, and delta is strictly positive. Okay, is pre-compact over Gromov. So in fact, what we get, you get as distance converge. Okay, so what we get, what is the limit space? So this is the metric you have. You have a pseudo distance. Okay, and you identify point where the distance are zero. Okay, so drawbacks is they can have such a point, so the topology can change dramatically. Okay, so problems. Okay. Okay, it makes it possible to build example where this is you collapse a hypersurface to a point. Okay, and first, this it is also possible that f, if you take a sequence, can be unbounded. Okay, this is, and there are another problem. The limit could be not conformal to J0, because a priori you say, well, perhaps the function converge in some weak sense, you are conformal to a strange factor that oscillates, can vanish somewhere, and you can, but this is not conformal to J0. And even you have example, and even not Riemannian. Okay, so I'm going to give an example, the well-known example that gives you where this picture occurs. Okay, and for the moment we are not. Then I will give another result that is kind of a reinforcement of this one, where we remove this condition. So the topology then changes. You have really a distance on the manifold M. But so let me give an example to illustrate the difficulty. So it is not an example where you have these conditions. Okay, but it is an example where you have compactness and you understand what is the limits. And okay, so on the torus, okay, and you take the following matrix. You take a matrix that is conformal. The Platt matrix. Okay, and so it's very nice. You know, the associated distance, okay, is bounded by from the Euclidean matrix, so the flat matrix. Okay, it's easy to find this one. Okay, this conformal factor is bounded between some constant and another constant. So it's really Lipschitz at every point. And what happened is that topology, and this is to a Finsler metric, and the Zinsler metric is associated to the stable norms of the periodic on Rn that is given by okay, this is the periodic matrix. You take at large distance, the geometry look like a Zinsler matrix. Okay, so the geodesic distance for this matrix at large scales is at bound distance, if you want, from the Zinsler norms. And this Zinsler norm is the one that you will get by scaling on this manifold. So at the end, you have a sequence of smooth metrics that are all conformal to a given one. They are all Lipschitz. And it converges to the Gromov-Hausdorff to a Zinsler metric. So it's not conformalist, nor not Riemannian. Okay. So this is a phenomena that, for the moment, we are not able to rule out by geometry hypothesis. Okay. So. Okay. So what we find quite convenient to circumvent the first problems is a concept that came from harmonic analysis and that is due to Rn to David and Sims that we can easily adapt on any metric space. And this is a concept of strong R-infinity weighted. Okay, so this is come from things in 82. So in this context, what does it mean? It means that, in fact, it's something on the measure. To be strong R infinity with constant D if you get two conditions. Is first that this measure is doubling with respect to the ball of your original matrix. Okay, it means that the volumes. You take a ball for the metric G0 okay, is controlled by B times the volumes of the metric okay. So and the diameter. For G0, you get this. Okay, so the volume of ball, so it's something that compares the geometry for GF from the geometry for G0. Okay, but it only compares in fact, it's a geometry that is associated to the volumes, in fact. Okay, so this is the first condition. And the second condition is the fact that so I will explain in a minute what is this. This is uniformly comparable to the distance for F okay, so if you get 2 points on your manifold, okay, what you can take is the ball center at x and of radius, the distance. Okay, so B xy is the geodesic ball for the metric D naught center at x. Okay, so in fact, by the doubling hypothesis, you can put either here it's a priori it's not symmetric in x and y, but this the ball center at x and y with this, they are the same volumes up to a fixed scale. Okay, so this is these two conditions. And so what David and Sims show in is if you have such a volume forms on Rn that satisfies all these hypotheses, David Sims shows that then you have all very nice properties. You have the conformal metric satisfies the Poincaré inequalities, they have clearly volume growth, and also you get the, for instance, the isoperimetric inequalities, the uniform isoperimetric inequalities from these assumptions for the conformal metrics. Okay, and what it is helpful for is that if you get this, it is classical to get an improvement that is from the volumes you get this higher integrability. Okay, so for some p that is bigger than n, and p, it depends on g naught and on b. Okay. So from this, as soon as you get this, you get Gromov-Hausdorff convergence. But also, because you have these two sides estimates, you don't have collapsing. Okay. So it clearly truly converge toward a distance that is, in fact, a builder equivalent to the ground the given one. So, okay, from this hypothesis. So now the question is under which geometrical hypothesis you are able to show that a conformal metric satisfies this kind of strong high infinity conditions. So this is our theorems. Again, with n g0, okay, then a constant, so epsilon, that depends only on, okay, we can give an explicit description of these numbers is term of a lower bound on the Ricci curvature for G naughts, volume of G naught, and the diameter of naught. So it's something that came from estimates, Sobolev inequalities, and so on, that you can get under some geometrical hypothesis on G naught. So it's kind of, we can make it explicit. Okay, so that's matrix with first same volumes. And the fact that we do not have concentrations in Ln over two norms for the scalar curvature. Okay? It means that if you take R naught positive, and the fact that so this is for the metric G naught, okay, the ball, you do not get concentrations in the Ln over 2 norm of the scalar curvature. Then after extractions of subsequence, okay, you get that D Fk converge. And moreover, is to the original matrix. Yes?
Epsilon.
Yeah, it's epsilon, excuse me.
Sorry, the V is a universal constant or?
No, it's not universal, it depends on G naught. So it depends on the rich, lower bound on Ricci, upper bound on diameter, and lower bound on volumes.
The question was for the V.
V is a number, so it's set, so assume that all you have a fixed V. Okay, you have sequence of of conformal matrix with fixed volumes. And was scalar curvature do not concentrate too much in Ln over 2. Okay, so the proof is to show that, in fact, such a matrix are indeed satisfy those conditions. Okay, so okay, so before finishing, I'm going to give only two words on the proof how we get this result. Okay, so the first step is analytic steps is to have a better understanding of the conformal factor. That F is U plus V. Okay, it can be decomposed, the conformal factor, a matrix that satisfies these conditions here, where the first one is bounded in W2N over 2. That is to say U has two derivatives in Ln over 2. It means that if it was true for F, it means that F has certain curvature that are bound in Ln over 2. So it is a part, okay, where you improve the scalar curvature estimate to estimate on the full curvature tensor. But then you have some dust, V, and V is older continuous. Okay, so this is bad because this U can be unbounded, but this one is quite nice, it's only older. And everything can be quantized, so you have bound on the WN 2N over 2 norms of U, and you get an estimate on the older continuity exponent for V and the older norms of V. Okay, and from this, so this is the hard part, and then we adapt. It's not difficult. It's a result of Bonk. Saxman. What they show? They show that on Rn, if you take the lambda, the Lebesgue measure, is a strong R infinity weight. When you get okay, so if you get such a bound on Rn, then you get the strong R infinity conditions. Okay, and then from this we know that so it's not it's older, so it's bounded. Okay, so you get two metrical Billy-Pschitz, and then you use the adaptation of his result to get the B-older equivalence between the two distance. Okay, so I want to stop here. Thank you. Yeah, it's only the R is to say that at this scale, so R is fixed.
But doesn't matter what it is.
Doesn't matter what it is.
Okay.
Okay, but it's fixed within the sequence.
Yeah. Okay.
Any other questions? Okay, if not, thank you very much. Thank you.